The Midland Theater here on Main reopened its doors just a few weeks ago. The Empire down the block is set to do so in 2009, and eventually the Kauffman Center for the Performing Arts will be part of the mix as well. But all along, the Lyric Theater has continued to be home for Kansas City's Lyric Opera.
Kansas City's Opera Company is celebrating its 50th anniversary, and they started the season this year by performing the same opera they did 50 years ago. La Boheme.
Yeah, we thought it'd be a perfect time to look in on the state of Kansas City's professional opera company, discuss why some operas managed to stand the test of time,
and introduce you to a local internationally known singer who was part of the cast.
La Boheme has been performed for over 100 years. It's one of the most frequently performed operas in the repertoire around the world, which says to me there's something in this piece that relates and speaks to people. The way I got into opera, actually, I grew up in Philadelphia. I was a student there, and when I was in college, someone offered my father free tickets. And to tell you the truth, I didn't really want to go. It was Cinderella, Cenerentola, and I went, and the next day I bought season tickets. It was absolutely overnight, and I became something of an opera buff. There's something about the music and the story and the emotions. And it must be that the music helps me experience some of those emotions.
Danny Belcher also discovered his love of opera in college at William Jewell. He still calls Liberty home, even though he spends most of his time on the road performing in opera houses around the world, places like Paris, Tokyo, and Berlin.
This is, I believe, the third time he's performing with us. The last time was when he was the barber in The Barber of Seville. And it's interesting about his appearing as Marcello. Marcello is a smaller role than the barber, and usually a singer would first do a Marcello and then be invited back by an opera company to do Figaro. But Danny called us up and said, I want to be home with my wife and my baby. I would love to do Marcello, even though technically my agent might say you should be going in the other direction.
My character is Marcello the painter, but he's also the confidant of Rodolfo, and in the very important Act Three, which I find the most intimate, most spectacular part of the score, Marcello becomes the conduit for their love in a lot of ways. When I was going to college, I thought I was going to do musical theater. And as I started studying voice, my voice started going in a more operatic direction. And then as the world of opera kind of, you know, studying it kind of opened up to me, I realized, well, hey, opera is musical theater. At the time, karaoke had become one of the popular trends. And I thought, one night I'm gonna sing Old Man River. Don't ask me why, but I did. Well, this lady comes up to me from the Lyric Opera. She gave me her card and she said, have you ever sung for the Lyric? So I called the next day. Indeed, I set up an audition and they offered me a part in the chorus. That was the first professional job I ever had while I was a senior at William Jewell. I guess that evening doing karaoke kind of ironically launched my career.
That career is in a field which many people still find a wee bit confusing. Recognizing that, the Lyric provides At Ease with Opera to help sort it all out.
Antonia, in the Tales of Hoffman, also suffered from and died of tuberculosis, making tuberculosis the most epidemic of all diseases in opera.
We try to prepare people for the opera. If someone wants to come to a lecture, hear something about the story, the music, learn a little bit about the actual performers, our Opera Guild holds a number of lectures.
I'm a first-time season ticket holder, but I've always gone to La Boheme when it's in town. And every time I leave, I cry because she dies. And I had a friend say, but you knew she died. And I said, yes, but it always makes me cry. So now I'm here to find out why she dies.
Opera goers, and perhaps more characteristically, non-opera goers, frequently scoff at the notion that terminally ill people would be singing their hearts out until the moment of death. Verdi, Puccini, and Offenbach demonstrated their clinical acumen, recognizing that it was typical of patients with tuberculosis to be awake, alert, and conversant until the last moment.
People who have never been to the opera say, what would you say to them to attract them to come?
It's great music, great tunes. If you're concerned that it's going to be in Italian or it's going to be in French, it's true. We do sing in a foreign language, but you've seen subtitles at the movies. We have subtitles above the stage so that there's a translation in English going on during the performance. So you will understand what is happening. I'll sometimes say to people, opera is the Broadway musical of 100 or 200 years ago, except the Broadway musicals that we're putting on the operatic stage are the ones that have survived for two centuries. So you know they're good. You know they have some kind of special appeal to the audience.